Pa pale weh. Berapa ria kamera, berapa ria. Aku cium nanti ya, joking. Alright, I'm ready right now. So, today we'll be talking about regional dialects. So, I'm going to give a brief explanation what is regional dialects. So, in Peninsular Malaysia, there are three main regional dialects. First, which is the East Coast, second, Northern dialect, and the third one, Southern dialects. The fourth one is Borneo, which is two, they has like two main regional dialects, which is Sarawakian and Sabahan dialect. So, in this video, I'm going to talk about Borneo and East Coast dialects. So, some common and some popular dialects that might be used in their countries. So, I hope that this video will help you guys, like you guys from other countries, to like interact easier with the people around. So, want to learn that now? Basically, yeah, right? Alright, let's go! Okay guys, so today I'll be sharing with you guys five regional dialects. The first one, we'll start off with Kelantan. Kelantan, the first word is Ria or Ya. It which is means money, ringgit. So, example of the sentence I'll give is Berapa ya? Which means berapa ringgit? How much is it? If it's in English. Second off is make. Make means makan. Makan means eating. Obviously, we people likes to eat, right? So, example sentence I'll give it from here is nak make gapo ni? Which means nak makan apa hari ni? What would you like to eat today? Okay? So, that's the two words from Kelantan. Next, we'll move up to Pahang. The first word for Pahang is awak. I say again, awak. Awak means awak, which means you. Yes, you right there. It means you. And awak sentence would sound something like awak nak pergi mana tu, which means where would you like to go? Next up, this is pretty funny, but it's pretty interesting, which is called Popalewe. Popalewe is not really like a good sentence, but it's a good sentence because it's more like expressing yourself. You know, something like, whoa, yo, it's like expressing yourself, you know? So, Popalewe, how would we like to use this sentence, this word? How would we like to use it? That's easy. It's just, Popalewe, besar rumah awak ye, which means, wow, you have such a big house. So you're expressing yourself right there. It's like you expressing yourself by saying Popalewe. Sounds interesting, right? Third one, we'll move to Terengganu. In Terengganu, I also will give you two words. Don't worry, it's easy. You guys can do this. The first word is Kabar. Kabar means beritahu. Beritahu means telling, means I'm telling you something. How to construct a sentence from this word? It's easy. It's just by saying eh nak khabar ni, which means eh nak bagi tahu ni. Like you want to tell someone something, like hey, I want to tell you something. It's about the same. So let me repeat the sentence. Eh nak khabar ni, which means hey, I want to tell you something. Okay. All right. Moving on to the second word for Terengganu is se. What does sir mean? Sir means satu. Satu means number one. So that's one. Alright, I'm repeating one. So how are you going to construct a sentence with sir? Should be easy because it's number one. So everything's number one. So it'll be something like, boh, milo panas sir, means nak satu milo panas. Boss, nak satu milo panas. So it's like, hey, can I have one hot milo? It's something like that. Alright. Moving on to Borneo, we have Sabah. Alright, Sabah, yes. So for Sabah, the first word is cium. Don't get aroused. Cium, okay? So cium is not kissing. I'm serious, it's not kissing. In Sabah, it means smell, okay? So you're smelling something. It's like you want to smell something. How are you going to construct a sentence with cium? Bukan saya nak cium awak. That's not a sentence, that's a bad sentence, okay? So the sentence is cuba kau cium dulu bau tu, which means can you smell that food first? Something like that. But you guys get the concept, right? It's like you smelling that thing first. Second up, we have bidak. Bukan bidadari. Bidadari cantik kan? But for this one, bidak which means tak cantik, not beautiful. Okay. So, how to construct a sentence with bidak is baju ni lawa ke bidak, which means is this shirt nice or not? Okay. Okay. So let's move on to Sarawak. For Sarawak, it's a bit interesting because I wouldn't say it's similar to Sabah since both is in Borneo, but maybe the accent is kind of like similar. So the first word is ikan pusuk. What is ikan pusuk? Anchovy. So how are you going to construct a sentence with ikan pusuk? That's easy. Which is, kita ada nyual ikan pusuk si. Which means, do you sell anchovies here? Got it? I hope you got it. The second word will be balloon. I repeat. Balloon, not balloons. Balloon, okay? Not hot air balloon, not anything. This means airplane. So, balloon means airplane in Sarawak. So, constructing a sentence with balloon would be like this. Tadi kami datang make balloon ke situ. I repeat again. Tadi kami datang make balloon ke situ. Which means, just now we use the airplane to get to there. Like, get to somewhere, okay? So, that's all the words we have for Sarawak. But before that, I have a fun fact for you, which is, so in Sarawak, roti means biscuit. I'm not kidding. It means biscuit. I mean roti. We usually say bread, but if you go to like Sarawak shops, you say nak beli roti. I want to buy bread. But in English, it doesn't count. But in Malay, it's like nak beli roti. They literally give you. Biscuit, because they don't know which kind of bread you're talking about, which kind of roti you're talking about. So that's a fun fact about Sarawak. Okay? Alright, so that's about it. That's all we have for today's dialect. I hope you guys enjoyed today's segment. If you guys would like your regional dialects to be in, do smash the like button and just comment it down below. We would like to do your dialects too. I mean, I would like to host your dialects too. So give some new ideas. Hit the like button. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell button so you guys will be notified for your videos and the future videos. Thank you so much. See you again next time.